Let's check on European markets first. They're down for a third day, with the tech sector leading losses amid reports of tighter export restrictions from the U.S. and escalating geopolitical tensions fueled by comments from former U.S. President Donald Trump on Taiwan. The worries overshadowing data that showed inflation in the Eurozone slowed in June to 2.5%. As for Wall Street, futures are also pointing to a negative open, with the S&P 500 and the tech-heavy NASDAQ seen falling more than 1%.
Here's some stocks to watch out for. We're monitoring shares of global chip stocks as trade worries rise. Shares of ASML shares are down 8%, while NVIDIA and TSMC are slumping in pre-market trading. Also in focus, shares of Adidas after the German sportswear brand again hiked its full-year guidance, having beaten expectations with its second-quarter results. Adidas shares jumped 3.5%. We're also keeping a close watch on shares of Pernod Ricard as it agreed to sell the majority of its wine portfolio to focus on its core business of spirits. The stock last traded higher by 2%.
Asian markets ended Wednesday trade on a mixed note as tech stocks fell on potentially stricter U.S. trade rules. The TAIEX index led declines, closing 1% lower, with the Taiwan-listed shares of TSMC plunging 2.3%. Here at home, the local bourse returned to positive territory, with the main index gaining 0.3%.
Exactly 10 years ago, the index was at 6,867. So we ended slightly below that. Basically, it tells you that our market is in a long-term sideways trend.
Yeah.
And this market movement is very typical of a sideways market where investors take profits at the first chance they get, because they have been burned too many times. So okay. Q2 earnings is just around the corner, and the market is continually pricing in changes to expectations for rate cuts. So we'll likely continue to see volatility in the market, but mostly moving within that 6.3 to 6.7 range.
Philippine business groups backed the proposed total ban on offshore gaming operations. In a statement Wednesday, 8 organizations warned POGO-related crimes could hinder growth and affect investor sentiment. They also urged the government to ensure opportunities for workers and industries that could be affected by a ban. The groups, which include the Elite Makati Business Club, said they support foreign investments that are legitimate and those that would provide quality jobs for Filipinos. Meanwhile, Senator Sherwin Gatchalian also calling on President Marcos to announce the ban during his third State of the Nation address. Gatchalian says at this point, there's no more sound argument that could support allowing offshore gaming hubs in the Philippines. He adds, peace and order must never be sacrificed for revenue.
Knowing him, that he is monitoring this situation very carefully. And I hope that during the SONA, he will make that pronouncement just to ban POGO. He has the power to completely stop this operation, just like when we stopped Isabong in the past. And I am sure, I'm very sure that the president is monitoring all the activities surrounding this controversial POGO. And my wish is for him to clearly declare over during the SONA that POGO is no longer welcome in our country.